Welcome back. Have you made your New Year's resolution yet? If not, our next guest is here to help. Licensed marriage and family therapist Susan Harrington is back to talk about finding resolution success in 2021, including 5 things we can do every day to better our lives this year. Happy New Year, Susan!
Happy New Year. So lovely to see you on this great day. It's 2021. Hot dang. We made it.
We made it. Thank goodness. And it's really interesting what we're talking about today because we all know New Year's Day is traditionally a day when we make changes. You know, the new year, new me. What can we do to make 2021 a better year than 2020?
So that's so important. You know, we have all this hope for 2021 to be absolutely different. And the way to start that is to just start with the biggest thing possible is an attitude adjustment. We've thought very negatively about 2020. If we think and be more positive about 2021, if we believe in our abilities, that'll make all the difference. Social media has taken on this blame everybody else perspective. And it's important that what we do is we shift that to what are other ways of looking at things, what are other possibilities of how we can address this. Take on these different perspectives and remove the blame. And one of the things that helps us remove blame is to take responsibility for my actions and my reactions. And those are motivated by our emotions and our thoughts. And we've talked about that before. So if we make that shift, that'll make a big difference.
Perspective. That's something I've always learned. Perspective is very key. But it's interesting because, you know, New Year's is all about New Year's resolutions, right? But you believe that starting a New Year's resolution isn't the way to make our life better this year. Tell me why.
So it really isn't. You know, we think about starting on the first day of the year or starting a diet on a Monday and assigning it to these things. And what those kind of things do is support what the research shows, which is like 92% of us who do things like that, who word our resolutions negatively, who word them too generally, those sorts of things, that we fail. Within a month, 6 weeks, we're done. We're back to our old habits. It's hard to kind of start those new ones. And so if we make a shift around that, if we just do a little piece at a time, not do a big chunk, just pick one behavior, make a little shift in our routine, that helps to lower the fail rate and increase the success rate.
Exactly. You have 5 things we can start doing every day that really can help us in 2021. I find it fascinating. We've talked about it. Tell me about these 5 things.
So the 5 things that are listed there, I first want to affirm that doing this each day, and if that means we have to slowly incorporate an aspect of each until eventually by the end of the year, we have it all set up. The rewards we get from that are really big, right? So our energy is increased, our anxiety and our stress and our anger is decreased, our frustration, our mood is elevated. We feel more happier in our lives. And our focus, our attention, ability to do that is also increased. And the biggest one is we have a sense of calm and a sense of recharge when we start each day. So who's not looking for those things?
You know, I've written these down already and I'm going to incorporate this in 2021. But it's interesting because there's something else that we can do in 2021. I know there was some research that came out after Hurricane Katrina. Tell me a little bit more about what you found in that research.
So that research is really interesting. Hurricane Katrina provided psychology an ample space and millions of people to look into how are they going to get through a time when their emotions are intense, the resources are low, the community's in distress. How are people and families going to live? If everybody remembers, our biggest issue is you didn't have a job, you didn't have a home, and you didn't have school for the children. So how are you going to rebuild? The whole community was in distress. And so they looked at this. And this is called resilience, these things that help us rebuild our normal lives, these things that help us rebuild and muscle through even when we're having intense emotions. So this is called resilience. And it's really simple. Again, we have just a few things that we've learned. The first one is about incorporating social support. So when we incorporate social support, what we get back is this connection and hope. We need to see ourselves as capable of positive change. If we keep a negative attitude, that's not going to help us. And so that attitude adjustment we mentioned earlier is really, really valuable. The next is to be open-minded. So if I'm open-minded and I'm curious, that's going to help me be more interested in what are other possibilities, which is something we mentioned about earlier in the first question about perspective. Then this number 4 says to incorporate a we concept. So this is a really interesting aspect. We think of New Year's resolutions as an individual experience. when what we've done at Maison V is we're so family focused. If you go to our website, maisonvneworleans.com, on our learning page, you will see there's an article about family resolutions, a list of a whole bunch of things that families can do together to help joining, connection, hope, positive experiences, all those things, really great stuff. The next one we can do is self-care. So those five behaviors that I mentioned earlier, as a family, we're eating healthier meals, you're gonna cook together as a family, eat together as a family, walking together, the whole list is all really possible. Those things each day will really assist us in making sure we can muscle through. Then the last one is to identify hope and meaning. That one is huge. All together, all these things we're talking about today really help us to be more hopeful and have more meaning and to change these things. What's amazing are those five pieces we talked about earlier with the sunshine and the walking and the social connection and the water and the food. Those things, that what we've learned is those things help people not be depressed, literally not be depressed. It's pretty awesome. And so when we put them all together, these six and those five, an attitude adjustment, it's the easiest way to go. I really want to encourage people to consider these options.
Thank you, Susan Harrington. And hey, if you need someone to talk to, pay a visit to Maison V. They are located in Tarrytown at 1799 Stump Boulevard. You can also give them a call at 504-452-5937. Now, look, we have to take a commercial break, but stay right there. Much more to come on our New Year's Day show when we come back.